If you're a Sprint user, the end is near, one way or another. Stay tuned. How you doing? My name is Jacob Bell. I'm the CEO of Bell Enterprises, and welcome to my channel. We are actually on the road right now. We are in a little town called Lyman, Wyoming. We're driving across the United States to California to my family. Matter of fact, in the background, you will see my lovely wife. You want to put your head in the camera, say I got the wife and I got the baby. So we're in this little motel. We had a really severe winter storm come in, and so we're here for the nights. Well, it's actually morning. We were here last night, and there's a lot of snow. Anyway, so you are here for Sprint. Now, in case you guys don't know, Sprint is actually just got approved by the DOJ and the FCC to merge with T-Mobile, right? So T-Mobile is currently the third largest wireless carrier out there, and Sprint is the fourth. And so Sprint's been having a lot of issues. Matter of fact, their chairman and multiple people on the board have said that their business model is unsustainable. They're no longer competitive. And you can see that in the recent decline. Matter of fact, since 2004. So how did Sprint get here, right? Well, there's a lot of mishaps, a lot of missteps that were done by management, because Sprint had a complete monopoly on the market. A lot of people don't know that Sprint was actually one of the very first, actually the first carrier that provided wireless local and long distance networks. And so I'm going to kind of give a little bit of background on how Sprint got in this position and how this $26 billion merger with T-Mobile is going to be fairly epic. But there's actually a lot of states. Matter of fact, there's 15 lawsuits from 15 different states, including Washington, D.C., that's trying to stop the merger because they believe that with Sprint and with T-Mobile coming together, they'd be a less competitive market. And so that's their stance right now, where Sprint is either the merger's going to happen or they're going to go Chapter 11 bankruptcy. So in the 70s, matter of fact, so Sprint actually stands for the Southern Pacific Railroad Internal Telecommunications. So that's where the acronym Sprint came from, is that they actually put together all of the telegram wires throughout the entire railroad that they were using for telegrams, and they were turning it into a wireless type network for people to talk. And so that was how it first started. Matter of fact, so they were using this telegram network to communicate with people, and then back in 92, they actually acquired a company called Syntel, and so that put them into the wireless network. So not only do they have that old telegram network, but now they got into wireless. And again, they were the only ones that were producing that, you know. And so they were kind of doing their thing, you know. They were doing well in the market back until 2004, where they managed acquired or merged with Nextel. And so with that, like, that was supposed to be their golden child. However, the issue was that when all these other networks were going to the LTE networks, they were using a different type of 4G, and that 4G never caught on. So they really couldn't be competitive anymore in the market, and that's where the big decline started happening. It's really kind of crazy. So they are actually, Sprint was actually bought out by a company, I believe it was called, SoftBank. So SoftBank is really big in telecommunications and software. And so SoftBank came in and bought them out. And then they tried to merge with T-Mobile back in 2013. However, it was barred, right? So now during this merger, the only thing they have to go through is they have to go through trial now with these 15 states and Washington, D.C., or District of Columbia, however you want to look at it, to get this merger done. So they have to beat them in trial before the merger can happen. But when it comes to the federal regulatory systems, they've already passed. So it's really up to this. And again, if it does get blocked because of these different lawsuits, I mean, all the analysts and even people internal with Sprint have declared, and they've been hinting at Chapter 11 bankruptcy for quite some time. And so when they do that, they're going to restructure the assets, and so they can eliminate debt, restructure assets, and then they can start investing into 5G, But here's the problem, because even though Sprint has been working on some 5G or 5G projects in certain metropolitan areas, very few, they are no longer competitive with the massive 5Gs that these other big companies are doing. And so with this bankruptcy process, it's going to stall a lot of the investments and a lot of the furthering of their 5G networks. And so they're already non-competitive now. Now they're going to be extremely non-competitive or even non-existent when this bankruptcy finally goes through and they can move forward. And so matter of fact, some of the sources that have been talking to Fox as well as CNN have been saying that if this merger doesn't happen, they're more than likely not going to be able to bounce back and be competitive anymore. And so that's really, it's not really a scary thing, because Sprint is just going to discontinue services and then, you know, send them to somebody else. So it's really going to look like the merger is more than likely going to happen. As long as, you know, as long as the acquisition team can have a decent trial, because the problem is that you're going from four very large carriers to three. And so they're saying that because that is, you know, you're taking away 25% of the large carriers that are able to keep the market competitive. They're afraid that's going to start monopolizing thing, but Sprint is kind of becoming such a non-factor. Even though it is the fourth largest, it's declining so rapidly. And the problem is that Sprint was like, okay, well, our network isn't the best, but we're not going to charge the most money. Like, our network's not the best, so we're going to have this really, really low price points. And so that's going to attract some people. But now, because wireless coverage has become so standard and so large, and then, for example, Verizon and AT&T, they're able to offer these really superb networks and charge about the same what Sprint's charging right now. And so that allure has really gone away. And so, again, it's a very difficult time for Sprint. If you're a Sprint user or a Sprint investor, these are some significant red flags that I would probably start looking at going somewhere else, either with my money or with my service, because it's looking like, again, if the merger does not happen, it's going to be all bad news bears for Sprint. So all the eggs are in this one basket for this merger to happen. So hopefully it goes through. Hopefully, you know, Sprint consumers can go over to a better network, and this can really help everybody out. So again, Jacob Billet, CEO of Billet Enterprises. This is kind of an impromptu Trending Tuesday because I am on the road. So hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will catch you guys later today for Power Networking at 2 o'clock Mountain Time. Later. We'll say bye.